Hi there, my name is Dan. You and me are going to learn how to create our full screen background video website, both the video creation and building the website. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi, welcome to this video. This one, what we're gonna do is talk about what happens when you've got a really old and slow computer and you need to kind of speed it up a little bit. And it might be working okay till now, but as we go through this course, we're gonna do some more hardcore animation and you'll find After Effects getting a bit slowly. What happens to the best of computers? Okay, so what we need to do is just figure out a few tricks to kind of get it going. It'll always output fine. It's more the previewing that we need to fix with. So we need to see this preview window. If you can't see it, go to window. There it is there, preview. And if you're on a big, nice big screen or an iMac, you'll probably see this whole view. But if you are like me on this laptop, watch this, if I drag it down, there's actually lots of awesome stuff in there. Hello. Okay, so that was hiding before, so you might have to make it bigger that way. Now, by default, watch this. You're looking at this little green bar along here. Okay, see this little green bar? If I hit spacebar, it's gonna try and render it. So it's kind of like going forward and trying to render it before my little playhead gets there. It's called caching, okay? It's just trying to get there and buffer and try and get ready. So it's doing it fine at this kind of speed and this animation, and my computer doesn't seem to be very stressed at the moment, which is awesome. So, and that's fine, but say it is running a bit jumpy. What you can do is you can say in here, I wanna skip every second frame. Because it's running really smoothly, showing you by default zero, so it doesn't skip any of them, so it plays it smoothly. But if it is, well, if it's running a little slow, you can say skip every one, please, or skip every, say, two. Okay, it's gonna run a little jumpy, but that might not be what, you know, you're not looking for pure quality now, you're looking more to kind of timing or just some kind of basic look of it. Now, I need to clear that green stuff. It's easy just to grab something and drag it around because it has to go and redo it now. Okay, so if I hit spacebar, look at the time. You see it's very different, it's got little green dots. So it's actually jumping between those two now and it's just ignoring the two frames in between. And so it can, like it's faster at keeping up with it, it's gonna buffer, longer. And like, you can see it's just a little jumpy there, but you might be okay with that at the moment because you're just kind of working on timing, or maybe see you're working with sound, that's a great way. Now your final output doesn't get changed, okay? It just stays, I'm gonna put mine to zero. It'll output every frame, but just while you're previewing, it's quite a handy thing to do and that'll speed you up a little bit. Now the next thing to do is to have a look under your preferences. So if you're on a PC, it's under Edit, way down the bottom here is Preferences. Because I'm on a Mac, it's in a slightly different place. It's under After Effects, Preferences, and let's go down to Media and Disk Cache. Okay, so a couple of things, Disk Cache. If yours is running really slowly, the reason mine runs really slowly often is because I'm running out of hard drive space. I've only got like 30 gigs worth of my laptop memory left, which is really bad, okay? That means that your maximum disk cache size, yours is probably a lot higher. All it means is that while it's working, it needs to store all your previews somewhere. And what you can say is actually, instead of storing like, I can't remember what it defaults to, 20 or 30 or 50, it stores too much on my one because it fills up my hard drive completely and my machine goes into like critical. I just made mine a lot smaller. It means that you can't preview as much or as long, which is fine for me at the moment. I'd rather it run fast. So you might play around with that one. The other thing you can do is say your hard drive is full or empty, or it's just a really old drive. I've got a really cool, what's called an SSD drive, which means it's just a solid state drive. It just means it goes really fast and it's really quick. So I like to use my SSD drive because it's super fast. You might have a really old laptop with a really slow old hard drive. I'm not gonna get into it, but you can get slow hard drives and fast hard drives. What you could do, especially if you're working with really big files, is you can actually choose where to store these. Instead of storing them on your hard drive, like I am, you can say, actually, let's go choose a folder, and you can actually plug in, like here, I've got an external drive here, you go plug it into that one and say, store them over there. The only trouble with that is you just gotta make sure you've got a reasonably fast external hard drive. So check how fast it is and how fast the connection between it is. If we're getting a little nerdy, sorry. Okay, but yeah, trying to make it just go fast. The other thing you can do to make things go fast is, if you're looking to upgrade your laptop, there's two things to upgrade. RAM is the quickest and easiest, okay? This little Mac has, you can tell how much RAM you have if you go to, where is he? Memory, okay, mine has 8 gigs of RAM, which is kind of, 4's bare minimum, 8's just usable, 16 is awesome, 32 is world winning. Okay, so it depends, just check how much RAM you've got. That's an easy one to upgrade, okay? It's cheap, it's easy, unless you're using a new MacBook Pro like mine, which turns out a bit painful, especially if you're a PC. RAM upgrades are like something even a novice can do in the afternoon, okay? Buy a new RAM that fits, stick it in there, take it into a shop, whatever. It's only a couple of $100 will get you some good RAM. That's American dollars, okay? RAM, get that upgraded. Okay, it's cheap, it's easy. The next thing, which is not as cheap and easy, is to upgrade your hard drive. If you've got an old tape drive, okay, which is most computers at the moment have tape drives, which have like spinning wheels in them, upgrade it to an SSD drive. So take it to the shop, say, I want an SSD drive. You'll have to pay, they're reasonably expensive. So a cheap one that's maybe half a terabyte is, it's still gonna be like, I don't know, $400. Okay, so it's pretty expensive, but it's an amazing thing to do, like for video especially. If you upgrade your, you might have to, because SSDs are a lot smaller size-wise, because that might be a big problem for you, but so generally about half of what you can get for the normal tape drives, but they're crazy. I've installed them a couple of laptops for our training centers, and it turns a machine that didn't handle After Effects, you know, it had maxed out RAM, but I installed an SSD drive and hey presto, it starts running really fast. That's a really cool thing you can do. All right, the last thing you can do to kind of make things run faster is upgrading a video card. Your video card is something in your machine that, yeah, processes all the video and it's, yeah, can be upgraded. It's probably the most complicated and painful of them all, but it can be one of the big benefits. But try RAM first, try an SSD next, and then go for the video card. And lastly, but not least, is to upgrade your machine. Okay, if you've got a really old machine, you planned on doing lots of video stuff, and it's just running, it's not usable, then you might have to look at getting an upgrade. All right, that's it for how to make your crappy computer run a little bit faster.